between these. Mouth. Why do the yellow cheeked cat try to get its horns piercing towards his mouth? And then it opens its eyes. The ocean floor trembled when the monster exposed its paws one by one. Nian meaning year in Mandarin. The villagers lived in fear. They prayed unceasingly, offering incense to their gods, built wooden spikes around the compound, but nothing could stop the monster. Year by year, the village suffered from the same fate. Death. New Year's Eve. Everybody was preparing to flee. Men were pulling on horses and cattle with all their might out of their barns. Women packing up important necessities from their homes. And children locking doors and windows. Everybody was so busy preparing to flee except for this one old man. This old man was odd. He was wearing filthy clothing. A walking stick on the left, and a loosely tied cloth on the right. With graceful white beard and twinkling eyes, this old man walked slowly. But he caught all the attention of all the villagers. They were saying, "Who is he? Never seen him before. Why is he strolling around?" The old man ignored all the stares and murmurs and continued walking slowly along the pavement. Suddenly, an old grandma reached out and grabbed his untidy. Grandma gave him food and advised him to flee while he had the chance. The old man refused and said, "If you let me stay in your house for one night, I will make sure to drive the monster away." Grandma thought to herself, "Delirious! What is wrong with you? Flee while you had the chance!" The old man refused again. To no avail, Grandma left, along with the rest of the villagers, to a remote mountain. Night fell upon the village. The monster trampled to wooden spikes like stepping on paper, hunting from house to house in search for the living, until it came to this one strange looking house. This house was different from the rest. It wasn't dark and all boarded up. In fact, it was bright, well lit, with scarlet paper stuck all over the main door. The monster let out a deafening roar. It charged through the door, ready to devour any living soul. Inside, there were loud explosions and bright, blinding lights. The monster grew terrified to go forward. Explosions after explosions went non-stop, pounding on the monster's ears. With every explosion, the flame sparkled in all directions, burning the monster. And at this very moment, the old man barged out to the door wearing a red gown and laughed with laughter. The monster was terrified. It took no time for the monster to flee the house. The next day, when the villagers came back, they were surprised to see that the grandma's house was untouched. The grandma remembered, "Oh yes, there's an old man that stayed in my house. I need to check on him." Grandma went. But the old man was nowhere to be found. All was left was red papers all over the floor with lit candles and burnt bamboos. That was the day the villagers found out that the magic keys to scare away the monster is the color red and explosions from bamboo firecrackers. And from that day onwards, every new year, fireworks were lit, people dressed in red, going to houses, celebrating with their neighbors on the victory on how they scare away the monster again. Fellow Toastmasters, such victory celebration can still be witnessed today. It has become a tradition and a huge part in the Chinese culture. With red being the theme for the new year, fireworks were lit to ward off evil spirits or the negativity from our lives. The legend of the monster Nian even evolved into an artistic performance symbolized by the lion in the lighthouse. With loud drums and fireworks, we can all relive the joyful moments that the villagers had in the past. Chinese New Year are also called Bo Nian, which means surviving. And this story has been passed down from generations to generations to remind all of us that we need to be positive with every passing year. There will be a sunshine after the storm.